ready, baby. We're gonna get them on. Oh, that's a fish on. Might be a permit. That's a fish on there, boys.
Put them on the cooler.
Up in the bell.
Woo! Wow! Yeah! Permit in the boat, baby!
Yeah, nice permit, baby.
First.
There we go.
First ever Florida Keys perm. Let's go.
On the crabby.
Let's do it. Nice perm.
Feeling permity these days. Yeah, baby.
Welcome to the MANG channel. We're down here in the Florida Keys. We're gonna plant some mangroves, but first, we're gonna go do some fishing.
Right now we're fishing Bahia Honda Bridge. We're floating some crabs out behind the boat. See if we can't get a neat. Hook up.
Screamer.
About to break the reel.
Loaded.
Ooh, pretty fish. Beautiful little fish.
There's tarpon right there. See him? Going right to left. He's right on the boat here. Oh, that's a fish on. Might be a permit. Get him coming back this way.
Put a little bit more torque on him.
That's a good permit right there.
All right, we got a permit on.
Permit on, baby.
See ya, Honda.
All right. Oh, through the bottom lip.
Got that tail.
That's a fish on there, boys.
Put them on the cooler.
Up in the bell.
Woo! Wow! Yeah! Permit in the boat, baby!
Yeah, nice permit, baby.
First.
There we go.
First ever Florida Keys perm. Let's go.
On the crabby.
Let's do it. Nice perm.
Feeling permitty these days. Yeah, baby.
All right. Beautiful Florida Keys permit. All right, guys. First Florida Keys permit. Let's go. On the prop dropper. All right, we're gonna put this boat in the water. Put this permit in the water. We were floating that crab right in the center of the span. Fish picked it up real light. And permit on.
Permit on. Oh, beautiful.
There we go, that's how it's done. That is only my second permit ever. All right, we just finished up fishing at the Bahia Honda Bridge. Now we're gonna run some backwater and check out some potential mangrove restoration sites.
All right, Mangs, we are out here at Friend Key. Behind us here is a island that was destroyed by Hurricane Irma. As you can see, there's a bunch of dead mangroves on this island. There are some that are still living, but they're in rough shape and slowly kind of recovering from the storm. This island used to be a giant bird rookery, so birds used to come here by the thousands and nest here on this island, and there are still some birds here. There's cormorants, pelicans that we see right now, but you know, compared to what it was back in the day, you know, there's hardly any species as far as in numbers as there used to be. This island is starting to disappear because there's no existing mangroves here that are living on this end. So a big reason behind why we're down here in the Florida Keys and we're replanting some of these areas hit by Hurricane Irma is to help reestablish those shorelines that if you don't come and help, they'll just wash away. Good morning, day two here at Pigeon Key. We're out early in the morning, seeing a beautiful sunrise. We're gonna be planting some mangroves down today. We're gonna go check the bridge real quick and see if we can't get on some fish.
Yeah.
So right now we're actually fishing on top of a seagrass flat and we're kind of just drifting some baits behind the bridge here. Seagrass is really a critical habitat and bottom structure for holding sediment down. And they're really, from an ecosystem standpoint, just as critical as mangrove habitat. In areas where we don't have seagrass, you have barren deserts where there's no food sources for fish and for animals, where you can go miles without seeing another fish. So when looking at the structure of seagrass, it's this network of rhizomes that spread across the surface of the sediment. Really, seagrass grows at a certain elevation where it can get a lot of sunlight, and that rhizome structure helps to keep the sediments trapped on the bottom so that there's not a lot of turbidity in the water in those areas where there's a lot of seagrass beds. And it's really beautiful to see how that rhizome structure holds down our coastlines between our mangroves and our coral reefs. Seagrass is that middle zone that helps to keep excessive sediment from flowing onto our coral reefs. And really that middle ground habitat for fish that are moving from mangroves to reefs. You know, when you're driving your boat, you want to be knowledgeable about where you're driving, because if you damage that seagrass bed, you damage those rhizomes, you'll see those prop scars for years after the incident happened, which is really sad to see, because once those rhizomes are disturbed, the seagrass isn't growing back into those deeper ditches most of the time. So as a boater, you need to be aware of the areas that you're traveling, because if you don't, you're destroying habitat that could be helpful for animals and fish. Being aware of your surroundings out here in the Keys and other shallow water areas in Florida is critical to helping preserve these habitats. Just like we preserve the mangrove habitats here in the state, seagrass are just as important. Early morning walk with some mangroves. Gonna go plant these guys down on Molasses Key. I'm gonna have a good time doing it. Just as much as we love fishing, we love planting mangroves too. So stay tuned. We're gonna show you guys how we plant these mangs down. So we're out here today on beautiful Molasses Key. So this is what we would call really a critical wildlife island. They lost so many mangroves from the storm. As you can see, there's open spots all around the island. This whole island was just completely covered with mangroves.
So heavy winds oftentimes will cause defoliation. That defoliation will cause stress. Then you also have heavy winds that twist the trunks. So as these root systems are shaking because of all the wind, little crevices are opening up, allowing a lot of salt into the trees. Sometimes trees will try to rebound right after a storm, but oftentimes, more than not, when there's heavy winds of Cat 4 or more, this is a lot of what we see. This will remain here for a little while, but once this starts to pull sediment away from the shoreline,
what we have is recession.
Mangrove ecosystems contribute directly to our offshore ecosystems by providing critical nursery grounds for all these things that really utilize this habitat to really move offshore and to help feed into our coral ecosystems. So it's awesome to see how fish that grow up in the mangroves then one day make it off to our offshore reefs and then help to really keep that whole food cycle of from mangrove to reef continuing. Without mangroves and without seagrass, you're losing critical habitat that then feeds into having fish at our offshore reefs. So that's why we really protect these ecosystems in order to make a larger difference in our fisheries and our economy and healthy ecosystems. So we got this side of the island planted. Now we're gonna go meet Frank on the other side, who's got the rest of the mangroves on the paddle boards, and start loading them down. So, woo, let's go, Mangs.
We are planting our last mangrove into the ground today. And boy, what a good planting it was. So we're wrapping up, stoked on what we just did.
If you guys like the content, please feel free to subscribe to our channel and hit that like button. Thanks for joining MANG TV.